A very good morning, students. I hope you all are fine and safe with your family. Students, in English, today we will be learning Unit 2, Lesson number 2.2, and the name of the lesson is The Souvenir. Before moving to the lesson story, I'm showing you all two images over here. These are the images which we call as a souvenir. What is a souvenir? Souvenir is nothing but it is a thing that is kept as a reminder of a person, place or an event. Okay students, so this is the meaning of the term souvenir. It is returned by, the souvenir is returned by Lakshman Lonthe, which is a story in the form of science fiction. It deals with a world that differs from our own as a result of new scientific discoveries, new technologies or different social systems. It is sometimes hard to distinguish science fiction from fantasy. Here you can see students, I have just kept an image of a girl which we can call it as Siley. So she gets a chance to visit, moon. So it has been arranged by the school. So what all things she has been experienced, it is going to come to know, we will be learning in this story. With the tip of her nose pressed to the window of the space shuttle, Siley sat gazing at the view for outside so long. Still, she didn't seem to be contented. She has read the description of this view several times before and had seen the scheme on the video too. Okay, so she's sitting near the window of the space shuttle and she's just looking outside. And she's very happy. Why she's very happy? Because all this thing she's seeing for the first time and it is very real. Okay, so students, what happened whenever we read any of the books? Okay, we see different images. But same image, if we get a chance to see in real, that is totally out of world experience. So same thing is given in the lesson also. But this was different. Reading the description was one thing. Watching the pictures and videos captured by the camera was another. But getting an opportunity to view that amazing panorama. Panorama, students, means what? A very wide view. Okay, a very wide view. With your own eyes being present physically right in the midst of it was indeed an out of world experience. No matter how long she sat gazing, her awe and wonder did not seem to abate. Abate means for students to reduce. So she was so happy that she must have read different books. She must have gone through different videos. She must have gone through most of the things. But now when she's seeing everything is real, for her it is totally out of world experience. The earth gradually began appear to get smaller and smaller in the sky. After sometimes what happened, as and when she was about to land, the size of the earth started getting reduced. Okay, and the azure blue sky was now looking jet black. Okay, so the sky was looking totally now black in color. The clouds got disappear and the stars were shining very brightly. This trip to the moon was very much expensive. See, it is not only few hundreds, we can say. It is very costly. It was very expensive. But then also, Siley's mother had sent her to the trip. Okay? So, what Siley's mother, when Siley told that trip is going on, so Siley's mother didn't hesitate and she was ready to send her daughter to this trip. Which trip? Trip to the moon. So, what happens when mummy, Siley's mother is saying that when she was small, she didn't got a chance to visit such long distance trip. Long distance trips means what, students? When we go very far away from our place where we stay. Okay, so that we can call it as a long distance. So this is what mummy is saying. Whose mummy? Siley's mummy is saying. So what further she is saying? The longest trip meant going to Europe. If you get this opportunity, make the most of it. Okay, so the longest trip was Europe. And now what the mother is saying, Sally's mother is saying, if you are getting this opportunity, now definitely you should make use of it. We should learn many things. So now what happens? Oh, mummy, Neha's grandmother was saying that. Now this what Neha's, Sally's mother told. Okay, so Neha's grandmother was saying that longest trip for school children used to be only up to Delhi or Kolkata. Okay, what Neha's grandmother is saying, it was most to most to Delhi or Kolkata, and it is so funny, said Sally laughing. Remembering that incident made her laugh even now. Now what happened, students? Now Shetil was getting very close to the moon and it started orbiting the moon. Every 32 minutes what used to happen? Shuttle used to complete one revolution around the moon. Light and darkness followed each other in quick succession. That means immediately after that what happened? Light and darkness used to follow. The dome-shaped settlements on the moon, which looks like igloos of the Eskimos, were now visible. The dome-shaped settlement which was there, it was totally visible, which everyone could then see. Okay, after some time what happened, student? Sally shuttle was there, slowly it started landing on the moon. And after that, the door of the shuttle was opened and children were escorted. Escorted students means what? Carefully taken, because first time they were moving. Okay, so first time they were doing, or they don't have any of the experience. So carefully, after, as and when the shuttle landed on the moon, slowly it was opened, and slowly they were being escorted through an airtight tunnel to the settlement at the Neil Armstrong base. So where they started to land, where the Neil Armstrong base was there. So then after some time what happened, one person was standing, the receptionist. Okay, the receptionist said the entrance to the base gave some instruction at very outset. Outset means what? As and when they landed over there, receptionist gave them some instruction, because we should know all these things whenever we are moving to a new place, whenever we visit to a place. Okay, and whether it is a factory or whether it is any of the resort or venue, something it is. So receptionist, who is the in charge of all this thing, she or he gives us some information. That means what we are supposed to do, because we are new in that place, we don't have any idea where we have to go. So immediately the receptionist at the very outset, she started giving some instruction. So what instruction she is giving, now we will be able to listen that. So first she gives a very good welcome to everyone. Okay, she welcomes, I welcome you all to the Neil Armstrong base. To make your stay on the moon pleasant and comfortable. That means everyone should be comfortable over there, and everyone wants that the place should be memorable one and it should be pleasant one. So what further she is taking, that she likes to take certain precaution. That means everyone should take certain precaution so that everything should run on smoothly. So whatever she is telling, everyone has to hear it clearly and carefully, to all the instructions which she will be giving. Okay, and one more thing she told, that till the time you all are staying here, all this instruction they have to follow throughout their stay. Further she says that everyone knows gravitational force of the moon is 1/6 of the earth. In human settlement on the moon, the gravitational force is equivalent to that of the earth has been artificially maintained. But outside those settlements, the gravitational force of the moon is at work. So we have to be very careful when we roam around there. So that means we have to be very careful when we are moving outside. The second point to remember is related to shopping on the moon. See, again, as I have told, souvenir. Souvenir, students, means what? Which we keep as a remembrance, okay? As a reminder of a place, of a person or an event. So when the students has visited that place, definitely they will be taking something. They will be purchasing something for their family members. So the most important instruction which she is giving now is, she is telling, whenever you are roaming here and there. So whenever you are interested in carrying souvenirs back home from the moon, please buy the articles only from the shop which are inside the dome-shaped settlements. The most important thing, students, what is that? Whenever they want to buy something, whenever the students want to buy something, they only have to purchase from that particular shop which is inside the dome-shaped settlement. They cannot purchase outside which is not at all dome-shaped settlement. There you will be assured of genuine articles. So if you are purchasing from that dome-shaped settlement, whatever they will be purchasing, that would be genuine article. That means very good quality. Do not buy anything from the unauthorized shops outside the settlement. What further she is saying, that if you want to purchase anything from outside, you should not try to purchase because that are unauthorized shop. And if you are purchasing something from, that is not of genuine quality, which is of not a good quality. And last what she saying, that she is wishing everyone a happy and pleasant stay on the moon. At the end what she say, a very happy and pleasant stay on the moon. That means these all instructions students, receptionist is giving at the very end, at the very beginning of the, as and when Sally and her group has landed on the moon. So till here students, we will be completing our today's video. What we have learned in today's video student, it is a trip of the children in which Sally is also there, and how Sally's parents are just back of Sally, that you should definitely attain this trip, and they are making the arrangement for the trip that Sally should go through it, okay, so that she will get a very good experience. So where the trip has been arranged? It has been arranged to the moon. So along with Sally, there are other friends also, so who have been attending this trip. So it was a very good experience for Sally, and as and when they landed on the moon, immediately the receptionist who was there, what at the entrance or to the base, she has given very good instruction which was to be followed by each and everyone. And because it was a new place, they were not at all aware how it is to be followed. But because of the instruction, because it should be a very pleasant one and it should be a memorable one, so some instruction was being given by the receptionist which was to be followed by each and everyone. I hope students, this much must be clear to y'all about the story. If any doubt is there anywhere, you can again go through the video, and the remaining lesson we will be completing in our next video. Thank you so much. A very good morning to one and all dear children. I hope you all are fine and safe with your family. Students, today in English, we will be completing with our same lesson, that is unit number 2, lesson number 2, and name of the lesson is The Souvenir. The Souvenir is a story which is a science fiction. A science fiction deals with world that differs from our own as a result of new scientific discoveries, new technologies, or different social systems. The story is taking place in 2069, somewhere closer to 22nd century. We have already in the previous lessons to the previous video students, we have learned about Sally, that the trip has been organized to moon. What all experience they are going to share in this video, we are going to learn. As we all know that it is a 3-day trip, and they have just reached that particular place, and receptionist is already given what all instruction they have to be noted at the entrance itself to the base. Now moving ahead with the story, A jam-packed 3 days program awaited the children on the moon. Jam-packed students means what? Very crowded. Jam-packed means extremely crowded. They don't have time only to think something else. According to Earth calculations, on the moon there were 15 days of daylight and 15 days of night time. The 3 days of the trip were going to be night time on the moon. So as we know that the trip is of 3 days, so all the students are very excited, and how it is going to be, they just are waiting for. The most important program of the first day was Skywatch. What was the first day they were? See, it was, as we know, it is of 3 days. So each and every day schedule is being planned. That first day you all are supposed to do this. Second, see, in school also students, timetable wise teachers comes and teach you. Anytime teachers doesn't come and teach you all, okay, and whichever period is that particular teacher only comes. So this is the schedule. Okay, so same way those students also got the schedule that first day they should do this, second day they are supposed to do this, and third day all these things to be done. The first was Skywatch. On the earth it was usually foggy and the stars were seen rarely and only very faintly. There was no atmosphere on the moon. On the dark background of the moon, the stars shone dazzling bright. The most attractive view was that of disk of the earth. So what was very attractive view? The attractive view was the earth's disk. In the moon sky, the earth looked 13 times bigger than the moon in the earth sky. It was also 70 times brighter. It was 70 times brighter also. The earth light fell on the moon. Whose light fell on the moon? Earth's light. Where it fell? It fell on the moon. This beautiful enchanting view made Sally and her friends ecstatic. Ecstatic means what? They became very happy. It also means extremely happy. On looking, see, first time they got a chance to view all this. So looking at the video, looking at the photos, that is totally different when we get a chance to look in the real. So as and when they get the chance to look in real, they become very happy. So that is the meaning of the term ecstatic. Now they fell asleep. So all these things they did, now they are feeling asleep, very happy, excited and comfortable at the same time. So they are very much comfortable with the new surrounding because they are very happy. First time all these things they are being watching. Moving ahead. So night sky students, Skywatch was the first day that they were supposed to do. Now second day, even second, each and every day, as I have told your students that it was 3 day trip. So each and every day they were supposed to do something. The schedule was being arranged for them. So now it was the second day, and what all things has been planned for them, we will come to know. The secondary attraction was the circus on the moon. We excited. If someone tells us also to, we will be just going and watching the circus. We feel very excited because it's a total new experience for us. Okay, students, we see that even though we have seen it many times, but each and every time we think of visiting that particular place once again. So second day, that was arrangement of circus on the moon. That was the second day's attraction. The unique feature of the circus was the sitting arrangement. What was the unique? Unique students means what? Totally different. So what was the attraction? It was first of all circus on the moon, and another attraction was the sitting arrangement. Sitting arrangement means what? How the way everyone are been allowed to sit. Okay? How in the way each and everyone is allowed to sit. That is called as sitting arrangement. Spectators. Spectators means what? The one who are coming and watching something. Spectators means what? The one who comes and visit and they are watching something. Okay? So the spectators were made to sit in the tent and circus were going on outside. Where were the spectators were told to sit? They were being told to sit in the tent. And where the circus was going on? It was not going inside the tent, but it was going on outside. Now imagine. High jump and long jumps were the special attraction. What were the special attractions in the circus? High jump and long jump. One gymnast jumped 27 meters high. So one gymnast was there. What he did in the circus? He jumped 27 meters high. That much high he had jumped. Both the days, Beside the main attraction, another time was reserved for visiting the various settlements there. That means first day was the sky watch and the second day was the circus on the moon. Beside these two things, other attraction, they were supposed to visit different settlement also. It was expected that students should spend some time for self-study also. It was also told to the students that self-study should be done. That means they should not only roam here and there, but self-study should be done by them. The teacher had assigned them the task of writing an essay and on how they spend their time on the moon. What teacher did? As sea students, we get sometimes essay also from the school. So this time when they had landed over there, so one essay they had got that how they had spent their time on the moon, what they have done that time, which places they visited, what they observed, etc. These were the things which teacher told them to do during their stay. Stylie and her friends had traveled far and wide and had done a lot of sightseeing. What Stylie and her friends did? They had gone each and everywhere and they had just go through sightseeing. That means each and every place they tried to visit. Now, moving ahead. Now was the third day. So, third day also something was being planned for them. The third day, the teacher took them to place of historical importance. What third day was planned? The teacher is going to take them for some historical importance. Okay, 100 years ago, Neil Armstrong had landed at this place. 100 years ago, what had happened? Neil Armstrong had landed at this place. Everyone, each and everyone were very excited that they want to visit that place. Okay, everyone was looking forward to visit to this historical monument as it was the oldest place in the history of a man on the moon. The first footprint of Neil Armstrong was preserved on the moon land. Beside the footprint was a grand statue of Armstrong. At the base of the statue was carved the first word uttered by human on the moon. One small step for a man, one giant leap of mankind. These were the words which was carved at the base of the statue. The another attraction for the student was that they were going to wear the space suits for the first time. So it is not possible. So, but another attraction on the same day was that one time they get a chance to wear those space suits. So they were very happy for that. Okay, then they were going to roam outside experiencing the gravitational force of the moon. So, along with wearing the space suit, they will also get the chance to roam outside and experience gravitational force of the moon. So, on hearing all these things, they became very excited and how the 3 days is they are spending, they also are not at all aware. Now, so again and again teacher, because they get the chance to wear the space suit, teacher is very much worried. Why teacher is very much worried? First of all, they are wearing the space suit and they are allowed to roam here and there. So teacher again and again she is saying, be careful when you walk dear children, don't run or sprint, you will fall. You don't run here and there, otherwise you will fall. Okay. And teacher was giving them warning again and again. But who was in the mood to listen? But what about the students? They were not at all ready to hear what the teacher is saying again and again. They were only in their own mood. They were only in the very, they were very happy that first time they got a chance to wear the space suit and they were just roaming here and there. And but teacher was very much worried. They hopped. They jumped and they started running here and there. What they did? They hopped, they jumped and they started running here and there. Now what happened? Roadside shopkeepers were there. Roadside, so, and what the, if you remember students, I have just started, I have told this at the beginning of the lesson only. So as and when all the students had entered the base, the receptionist is telling them, the in charge is telling that whenever till the time you all are staying, purchase from that. If we want to purchase something for our friends or for someone, they have to purchase from the shop which are inside the dome shaped settlements only, because there will be assured of genuine articles. Do not buy anything from unauthorized shop outside the settlement. These what, who has told all this? Receptionist told at the entrance to the base. These were the instructions which were being clearly told at the beginning only. But sometimes what happens, students don't hear all this instruction, they don't remember. So now what happened, roadside vendors, shopkeepers were screaming on the top of their voice. What they were screaming? Buy ornaments specially made from stones on the moon, very cheap, cheaper than those available in the shops in the settlement, cheaper and better, at least have a look. Okay, so these were the things which roadside vendors, shopkeepers were screaming, okay, at the top of their voice. Why at the top they were screaming at the top of their voice? Because everyone should hear. When we will hear, then only we will go and purchase. If we will not hear, why we are going to go in that particular shop? We will not go. For that purpose, they were screaming on the top of their voice. Buy sister, buy, I am selling these earrings really cheap. Again and again those shopkeepers were saying that just purchase it and these earrings are very cheap. Cheap means it is not costly, so you can easily purchase it. Then saying this, he approached Saidi and displayed the sets of shining stones earrings. So immediately one of the shopkeeper, he went and approached to Saidi and he started showing shining stones earrings. Okay. Looking at that, suddenly what happened? Saidi remembered her mother, because why she remembered her mother? Her mother must be wearing that kind of earring. So what she thought, if I will purchase this for my mother would be the most happiest person. Okay, looking at the earring, she immediately remembered her mother. Now tomorrow they were to start on the return journey. She had completely forgotten her mother in the last 3 days. She felt terribly guilty because of the jam-packed schedule. One time also she didn't thought of her mother. Why she didn't thought of her mother? Because she was so happy. She was so much busy this time. But now when she's looking at the earring and she's remembering her mother, she's feeling little bit guilty also. Why guilty? Because how is it possible? One time also the thought of my mother didn't come in my mind. Looking at all this, she becomes little bit guilty. Buy this sister, don't think much cheaper and better, take it. So now shopkeeper has to sell all these things. So many things he is saying, that it is so cheap and you can take this, you should not think so much, what for you are thinking, if you will keep on thinking you will not purchase, all these things he started saying. And what Saidi did now? Saidi looked around, the other children had proceeded ahead. Proceeded ahead means what? They already went ahead. Saidi, now she started thinking, okay, what she said now, okay. What is the price she is saying, and give me those red earrings quickly. So come and give me that earring quickly, and what is the price of that earring? Who's asking? Saidi is asking. Now what happens? Only 1000 rupees, replied the salesman. What salesman is telling? Of that particular shop, it is only of 1000 rupees. Saidi immediately paid the amount, took the earring and ran to catch up with her friends. What Saidi did? Immediately, as in when she came to know that it is only of 1000 rupees, immediately she paid the amount, she took the earring and she ran to catch up with the friends. Why she ran to catch up with the friends? Because friends had already proceeded ahead. Okay, they had already proceeded ahead and she is alone over there. So she warned that she should not be alone and she wants to be with her friends. Immediately she started running. So this much what had happened as in when she purchased the earrings. On returning home, Saidi told her mother very enthusiastically. As and when she reached home, she was so happy that it was, she has not at all expected that all these things are going to happen with her. Okay, she was very happy and enthusiastically. Enthusiastically means what, students? It means happily. She is telling her mother, mummy, look what I have brought for you. She is just hiding everything from her mother. We also do the same thing. If we have purchased something for our younger brother or sister or for our parents, immediately we don't show all these things. We waste our time sometimes. We just keep on telling them, no, you think what it will be, you think what it will be. Same kind of thing. Even Saidi is also doing, mummy, look what I have brought for you. Her mother picked up the earring. She exclaimed, hello dear. How am I going to wear such heavy earrings? So after taking those earrings, mother is telling, hello dear, how am I going to wear it? Is it possible for mother to wear Not possible, Shaili immediately realized her mistake. Shaili immediately thought, oh God, what I have done. I should have not purchased from that particular roadside vendor. Okay, Shaili had purchased the earrings in the field of moon's gravity. From where she has purchased the earrings? In the field of moon's gravity. Shaili purchased the earrings from outside the human settlement where the moon's gravitational force was at work. The gravitational force of the moon made the earrings light on the moon, but it became very heavy on the earth. Why? Because of earth's gravitational force. Okay, so these all things have happened at the end of the story. But already the earring was being purchased, so nothing it could be done now. So this was the story about the souvenir. It was about how Shaili had done, or what all things she has gone through, and how was the experience of her during her stay. So here we complete our this lesson, and I hope students, each and everything must be clear to you all. If it is not clear, you can again go through the video and can clear all your doubts. Thank you so very much.